How you doing, Manginas? Tanky Toddler here, bringing you guys Domination on Hard Hat. And welcome to Girlfriend Stories, episode 14. You see right here, it's kind of sped up. That's just because I'm trying to keep it under 10 minutes. Because my program, for some reason, won't upload over 10-minute videos to YouTube. And my other program won't upload them into HD. So I gotta fix that and fix some settings sometime soon. But anyways, last time we left off, I was telling you guys about Anna. And I have to say, Anna was probably my favorite girlfriend that I dated. I think I had the most fun in this relationship. I felt like it was the best fit and everything like that. Like, I thought it was going great, to be honest. I thought I was just having a lot of fun. And that's why I don't have a lot of, like, weird, interesting stories with her. Because I really don't remember anything that was really bad. You know what I mean? Like, we never really got in arguments. I don't remember a single argument. So, I'm sure there was some funny stuff I just won't remember. But, I mean, this was a while ago. This was at least 3 or 4 years ago, so just hard to remember. But, yeah, it turned for the worst. But before I get to that, something kind of funny I want to share. I'm not going to go into too much detail about it. But, she was my first. You older people might know what I'm talking about. Younger people, don't worry about it. But she was my first. And what's funny about it was that it was on April Fool's Day in a noodle company factory parking lot. So, it was just kind of a weird location. I think it's funny that it was on April Fool's Day. But it was fine. So that's all I'm going to say about that. But let's get to the end of the relationship. Like I said, 6 months have passed. I was having, it was a good time with her, I felt like. And then, so, there was, I don't even remember what day it was, but she came over, and hung out with me. She picked me up and we were in her car and, we happened to be doing something. Don't worry about it. And, all of a sudden, she started crying, and I'm like, what the fuck is going on? I'm like, what the hell is this? What are you crying about? And she said, she was still bawling, and she says, I said Nick's name. And so she said Nick instead of Ryan. And I was like, so pissed. If you didn't know, Nick is her ex-boyfriend. I probably should explain that. Nick was her ex-boyfriend, and I was like, what the fuck? Like, she hadn't been dating him for 6 months. And so I told my friend about it, one of my good friends, and I was like, dude, what do I do about this? And because, first of all, we were about 20 minutes away from my house. She drove me all the way back because we were in her car. And I didn't say a single word to her. It was really awkward. She was crying for most of the ride. I didn't say anything. I was just really mad and I didn't know what to say, really. And so she dropped me off and she was like, I really want to talk about it right now. I was like, nope. I was like, I can't talk about it right now. I said, I'm not going to say, it's not going to be productive. I'm just pissed off right now. So, and to be honest, at this point, people at work were telling me I should break up with her anyways. They didn't like her. I don't remember why. But, oh, I know why. She got mad, actually. There's one argument. She got mad, and this turns out to be super, super hypocritical of her in the end. But she got mad because at work, there's this two girls there. One girl that worked with me, and the other one was just a friend. And I was on the phone and sitting down laying, on these chairs, and the girl came up and sat on my lap. And, first of all, I didn't tell her to sit on my lap, and I didn't really think too much about it. It was just kind of weird, but I didn't really say anything. And so somebody took a picture of it, and they put it online on Facebook. So she got mad. She's like, girls are sitting on your laps at work. They're like half naked because they're wearing like their outfit. And I was like, oh my God. I was like, I work with them. It's fine. Like, we've been dating for this long, and you're worried about me cheating on you. It's like, it's fucking ridiculous. So what was I saying? Fuck, what was I just talking about? Oh, so I was, yeah, so after that happened, we didn't talk for a little bit. I was like, I don't really want to talk about, let me just have my space. We'll talk about it later. So, like, I told my best friend about it, and he's just like, dude, and he's like, maybe it just happened. Maybe it just slipped, you know, like that. And so I told people at work, and they were really mad about it. And she came, and this is when I was singing. This is back in the singing days. And she came and surprised me at work. And I came to my show, so she paid money to get in, and there she was. And when I was doing that show, it was really weird because we hadn't talked in, like, it had to be like at least 4 or 5 days. We had not said a single word to each other. And so it was just kind of weird. I was, like, really took back by it. So, then I saw her after the show. I was like, all right, I have to go out and say hi to her. And so I went out there, and I was still really upset. I was still really weirded out by it. And, like I said, I'd already thought about breaking up with her a little bit. Like, as much fun as it was, I don't know. There was a reason I wanted to kind of, I was thinking of breaking up with her. I think, I don't want to say I was bored, But I think we were just lacking the pizzazz, for lack of a better word, towards 6 months later. So I was like, maybe it's just not going to work. She's going to college. She did go to college in Nebraska. I was in Minnesota. That's an 8-hour drive. So I was like, you know what? I don't know if this is a short-term thing or not. So she saw me at the park, and I gave her a hug. And I guess as she left, she rolled her eyes and was mad I didn't kiss her, because we were still technically dating. And so later on, actually, I called her, and I was with my friends, and I was like, you know what, guys? I was like, I'm about to break up with Anna. I was like, so I'm just letting you guys know. And they're like, why, is she coming over? I'm like, no, I'm gonna do it over texting, I said. And they're like, what are you fucking doing? Like, you don't break up with a girl over texting, and don't do that. Honestly, it's a bad idea. But I know, did I say Ashley? I meant Anna. I knew what was gonna happen. So I remember breaking up with Ashley, trying to break up with Ashley in person. We talked for 4 hours. She was crying. I gave in. I knew Anna was going to cry a bunch. So I was with them. I was like, dude, I just have to do over texting. So I texted her and I was like, hey, it's just not going to work and all this stuff. I don't remember what all I said. And I was like, sorry, you know, we're breaking up. And all of a sudden, as soon as I sent that message, phone call. And I was like, fuck, I can't answer this. I'm with my friends trying to have a little bit of fun for tonight. And within, I want to say half hour, 17 phone calls, 11 voicemails. Her, like, every voicemail was her crying, and then there'd be one with her really mad about it. Be like, you know what, I don't care. It's not worth it if you're going to break up with me. And then another one of her crying. She's like, yeah, I didn't mean it. I know. And so I was like, my friend was like, no shit, no wonder you broke up with her over texting. You knew it was coming. I'm like, yes, I did. And that's why I had to break up with her over texting. And, the next day, we were having a party at my, the place where, I was, the place where some of the singing people, stayed at, and this girl, one of the girls that worked with me, tried to hook me up with this other girl, and we didn't really do anything, we did kiss, and it was the day after, I felt really weird about it, but, turns out, I found out something about Anna a little bit later, like, maybe 6 months later, and, because we had broken up, we didn't get back together at all. And so 6 months later, I was actually at a party in, like, Christmas. It was around Christmas time. And my friend was like, he texted me, like, a couple days before. He's like, dude, he's like, I got something to tell you. I'm like, can you just tell me over texting? He's like, no, dude. He's like, I need to tell you this in person. And I was like, oh, shit, what does this have to be about? And so I get to the party, and he waited until I was a little bit drunk. So I wasn't really, at this time, like I said, it had been a while since I broke up with Anna. So I wasn't too mad about it. I was mad. I was pissed. But I didn't let it affect my night because I was still having fun and I was kind of over the relationship. But turns out, well, first of all, he was having a thing with one of her friends who Anna liked at times but then didn't like. Like, they were like friends slash enemies because that girl would actually started doing stuff, I think, with Anna's ex. Turns out the whole 6 months I was dating Anna, she was cheating on me with her ex-boyfriend. The whole 6 months. So that's why there's the name slip. So she made up about blocking him. She made up about everything. She just completely lied to me for 6 months. And so it turned out, I thought it was the best relationship I was in to the worst. Because who does that? Who gets mad about somebody sitting on a person's lap when they cheated on you for 6 months? 6 months. The whole time we were dating. The whole time. She cheated on me with this guy. So it's like, you really, like, honestly, you told me, she said she loved me before and stuff like that. I was like, how can you say that? How can you say that you love somebody when for the whole 6 months you're cheating on me with your ex-boyfriend? And some of you guys might be like, well, it's a little hypocritical of you because you were talking to, like, 3 girls or 4 girls at once. The difference was that I made sure it ended within a week. I did date a girl. I did date 2 of them for, like, a week, 3, and the other one for 2 days. But I honestly did not do anything with either of them during that week. I hung out with them, but I did not kiss them. I did not do anything else with them because I really didn't want to be that guy, and I didn't like doing that. So I think 6 months is a lot worse. I think it's a terrible thing to do, to cheat on somebody like that. So I got really pissed about it. She still tries to talk to me every once in a while, but I don't really say much to her. And, yeah, and she admitted to it, too, because I called her out on it. So now it's on to some other ones, and that was probably the next longest relationship I had was a month after that, was for a month, and that was my freshman year in college. Otherwise, I still have some awesome stories coming up. There's still some weird stuff, man, so look forward to it. And I don't even know what girl I'm talking about next time, but there is going to be a girl, So I go 43-3. Stay hairy, Manginas.